Hey there, this is Erica from Ever Educating, and this channel is teaching tips, tools, ideas, and resources for college instructors, or really high school teachers as well in a lot of cases. So if that interests you, go ahead and subscribe below. But today, now that I have over 2,000 subscribers, and thank you so much for subscribing, I thought maybe you might want to get to know me a bit more. And so it's January, and so I thought I'd go over some of my goals for the year, as well as explain how I goal plan, in case, you know, you're like me and really enjoy these videos with just like goal planning for the year. I've watched quite a few already, and so I thought I'd create my own and give you a sense of how I'm doing, you know, my goals and my ideas for the year of what I want to accomplish. So my brother and I do the, you know, 18 in 2018, 19 in 2019, that kind of goal setting. So of course, I mean, that's 21 during 2021. Now these aren't all major goals. So I don't recommend you do major goals for all 21 of them. I have a few major ones and now a lot of them that are smaller, but still important to me. So for example, a small goal is declutter my bedroom. Right? It's going to take me maybe like a week or two, not, you know, 2 months to accomplish that. So I do recommend having big and small goals in your list if you are doing the 21 during 2021. And if you are, go ahead, let me know below. Maybe give me your top goals if you want to share as well. But for me, you know, how do I come up with them? I basically do different aspects of my life. So I have academic goals, lifestyle goals, and business goals. And in my lifestyle, it kind of encapsulates a lot of ideas here, health and not health related. So I'm going to go over like my two or three big goals of each category, not all 21, because we'd be here forever, to give you a sense of maybe ideas that you might not be thinking of, or just to get to know me a bit better, right? Which is the point of this video. And so for me, you know, starting off with academic goals just makes sense because I'm a PhD student. And this is the semester that I graduate. You know, the pandemic has really caused me to fall behind in my writing. And so this is a semester that's gonna get done, right? So of course, my first major goal is to graduate, right? So to have a PhD, to become Dr. Romero. And so that is a goal that I'll accomplish by May, which leaves me obviously the other half of the year for the other goals, you know, in case it takes a lot of time and effort, of course, to finish up revising my dissertation and defending and submitting it and all that jazz, right? Especially because I teach during the semester as well. So that's goal one that's really huge for me is graduate from my degree program and become Dr. Romero. And so alongside that goal, another academic goal that I have is create a academic writing habit, right? Because I tend to do large bouts of writing at different points in time, but I'm not consistent. So it's a lot of stress for me that I don't really need in my life. And so in this case, here's a tip for you for goal setting is if you have a major goal, have some minor goals that will help you accomplish the major one. So in this case, it's having that routine, right? Having that routine of revising a few pages every day, or maybe three times a week, creating a time chunk where I do my dissertation revision. So basically getting into a good, healthy academic writing routine is another goal for the year because obviously it's helpful now, but also going forward as well. Now, I already mentioned decluttering my bedroom as a small lifestyle goal, but I'm going to focus here on the health ones that I've created. So I'll give you an example of mental health, physical health, and emotional health. Okay, so mental health, I want to read 25 books for fun this year. Okay, so obviously I read a lot of academic research nowadays. I read a lot of fan fiction that I really enjoy and also that I use for my research, but I actually want to read like 25 novels, right? Or 25 books. So it can be, you know, non-fictional as well. But basically get a good sense of the newest books out in my field, the children's and young adult literature, or even just like business books that might interest me for my side hustle, right? And so 25 books, alongside all that fan fiction that I read is one of my goals for the year to kind of just get like, you know what, take a break from all like the work I'm doing and just read something for fun and for enjoyment. So that is something that I really want to do this year. And then, you know, for emotional health, right, I want to have a group hangout with my friends at least once a month. So of course now that'd be on Zoom, it wouldn't be in person, but I do want to have, you know, that aspect of, you know, community that's really been missing as of last year. You know, I want to put in more effort to have, hey guys, let's get together and just have a chat, you know, once a month. So different friends groups, maybe even individual friends, and just do at least one monthly, you know, Zoom call where we chat for a while and catch up with life. So that I think will really help me start strengthening the community aspect that's really missing in my life since 2020 and even before, because the PhD can be a pretty, you know, isolating experience. So I want to really bump up that friendship aspect of my life this year. And then physical health is creating a fun exercise routine that I can stick to. So this has been on my list basically every year. I struggle with it a lot. But this year, I think I have more hope. I did get a Switch last year, and I've got games that are fun, but also exercise-based. So fitness boxing, right? Which is basically you box to different songs, like kind of like a Guitar Hero, if you remember that game. And then Ring Fit Adventure, which is basically a quest game that you do like squats and movements in order to get energy for your character. And then the Dance Dance or Just Dance game as well for, you know, dance exercise. So basically here, I'm not big on like, let's go running or let's go cycling, right? I want to have something that's a bit more fun. So kind of gamifying my exercise this year to hopefully get in better shape and get more energy for my life. So that's three lifestyle goals that are all health related, right? And then finally, I have the business goals, right? So I have a YouTube channel, I have a blog, I have a Teachable website where I sell digital bullet journals and now a collection of high flex activities for teachers. And so I do want to obviously have goals for that aspect of my life as well, right? And so going over just two goals that I have for the business. So the first one is to reach 5,000 subscribers here on YouTube, right? So yes, last year was a big year for me in growth. And so I want this year to be even bigger, right? So I think, you know, 5K is possible, right? But it's still a bit of a stretch as well. And so again, like I mentioned with academics, you know, having small goals that help achieve the bigger goal. In this case, one of my smaller goals for my business is to have one live video every month, right? So one live stream every month to get more personal, more one-on-one time with my community on here, and really to have longer videos than these types that tend to be, you know, between 5 and 15 minutes. I want to be able to have, you know, a longer session of just let's talk to each other about this topic. I want to offer advice. I want to hear your own advice. And so that's another element that I'm going to add to my goal setting is to have these live streams. So those are 7 of my goals, or 8 if you include the Declutter the Bedroom one. And again, I have 21 total. And obviously, I don't need to accomplish all those to feel accomplished in the year. But I do like writing them down and seeing them in my digital bullet journal. So I know, okay, this is what I told myself I want to work towards this year. Let's see how many I can actually get done. And so some of them, I feel like have hard deadlines, like the graduation one. Other ones don't, right? So creating routines, okay? It's not a deadline, it's a lifestyle change that I wanna make. And so for you, I would really love to hear, you know, what are some of your goals for the year? Do you have a word of the year, right? And that's really popular. Last year, my word was energized. You know, this year, I'm still considering it. Energized is a word I really like as well. I'm considering doing, you know, adapt, right? So whatever comes your way, adapt to it. Because obviously last year, with everything that went on, I really struggled with my academic accomplishments. So in this case, you know, maybe I just want to have like, you know what, whatever comes your way, figure it out, right? So adapt might be my word of the year, but really I'm still considering it. So once I know, I'll leave it in a comment so you can see my word of the year. But I'll be curious if you have your own, maybe you can inspire me to pick my one word for the year as well. So that's a little bit more about me. You know, I hope you enjoyed this video. Click like if you did, subscribe if you don't want to miss out on any future videos about my teaching tips, ideas, and resources. I'll link below a few relevant videos that have these teaching tips in case you want to see more of my regular content on my channel.